Lajja Goswami, a star shooter, hit the bullseye at the Commonwealth Games. Anil Manohar Nayak commands an empire of 45,000 crores with L&T, is yet to take a casual day off in his 45 years long professional journey. Sudha Patel, a student who has reached the doctoral program at Sardar Patel University, was originally Sarpanch of the village Changa, and although she is visually impaired, her village has never witnessed a blackout for a single day. Satyanarayan Gangaram, the son of a carpenter and a man who ringed the telecom revolution in India, the person who took the yellow phone STD booths to the remotest corners of India, we know him today as Sam Petroda. These four great people have one thing in common: the soil they came from, the land where they learned the first lessons of their lives, Charotar. It is on this golden land, under the shade of a mango tree, and with the omnipresence of the creator Brahma, Takshashila of modern era, Vallabh Vidhyanagar took shape. One tree, one table, one dream, two visionaries, Bhailal Bhai Patel and Bhikha Bhai Patel, inspired by the leader of leaders, the great Sardar Patel. Bhailal Bhai, distinguished chief engineer who worked in Sindh, Maharashtra and Ahmedabad, fondly known in Gujarat as Bhai Kaka, on a command from Sardar Patel, took early retirement to bring higher education to the doorstep of rural people. Bhikha Bhai Sahib, a teacher for over 42 years, became a true comrade of Sri Bhai Kaka. At the age where people generally hang up their shoes, they tightened their shoelaces to become the front runners to accomplish Sardar's dream. On 28th March 1945, when India was yet to become independent and the education system was mere a trickle, they chalked out a blueprint of this rippling educational township. They created green spaces by planting thousands of trees, many of which are still blooming. Charutar Vidya Mandal came into existence as a registered trust 3rd March 1946, the day celebrated as Vidyanagar Day. Bhai Kaka and Bhikha Bhai, the creators, came to reside in a place which was amidst wilderness. To celebrate the secular spirit of unity in diversity, they got a Dalit to inaugurate the brick kiln, a Muslim mechanic to lay the foundation of the workshop, and a Brahmin to lay the first brick of the Vitthalbhai Patel Mahavidyalay. In April 1947, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel inaugurated Vitthalbhai Patel Mahavidyalay with the words, "Education without character is of no value. We must be intent on producing citizens of free India, but not helpless ones loitering for jobs." The young aspiring minds began to pour in to take the lessons in the fields of science and arts. The uniqueness of Charutar Vidya Mandal lies in its ability to use quality education as a powerful means of social transformation. Being fully aware that progress of nation very much depends upon scientists and engineers, starting an engineering college was the dearest dream of Bhai Kaka and Bhikha Bhai. The dream became a determination when Sardar Patel stepped in. He inspired them to approach Shri Ghanshyam Das Ji Birla. Magnanimous financial assistance from late Shri Ghanshyam Das Ji Birla and Birla Education Trust in 1947-48 helped in establishment of the first engineering college of the state. The plans of the building were prepared by Messrs. Master, Sate and Butta, the then well-known architects of Bombay. The first brick of BVM building was laid down by a farmer, Shankar Kaka. In November 1947, the entire 40,000 square feet area of the main building was brought up to the roof level. But not a single wagon of cement had arrived since January 1948, and the classes were to be started by June. Such hiccups could not dampen their enterprising spirits. They devised innovative solutions and kept the work going on. They decided to fit 3 to 4 rooms with provisional roofing. And on 14th June 1948, His Excellency Lord Earl Mountbatten of Burma, the then British Governor General of Independent India and the last British Viceroy, performed the opening ceremony of the magnificent building of BVM. Principal S. B. Junarkar, who had successfully piloted the NED Engineering College at Karachi for 15 years, was appointed as the first principal of BVM. A person habituated to a luxurious urban lifestyle and the comforts of a lavish villa, willingly occupied a humble one-room guest house in this remote area and took the ropes of BVM in his dexterous fingers. "The birth of this college is a romance in itself," were the words of Principal S. B. Junarkar on the first Founders' Day celebrations. With his excellent team of dedicated teachers, Principal Junarkar put the college on sound footings. The motto of BVM is "Work is worship," and it considers education as a mission, not merely a profession. Dotted with palm trees and flowering shrubs, the campus of BVM is impressive in its simplicity. Adding the wow factor to the campus is a statue of a Spartan, a youth of great courage and self-discipline. As the campus clock ticks away silently, the Spartan seems to whisper, "Struggle doesn't wear you down, but sparkles your inner strength." Originally, BVM was affiliated with Bombay University. Then after, it was affiliated with Gujarat University. From June 1957 to May 2007, it was affiliated with Sardar Vallabhbhai Vidyapeeth, renamed as Sardar Patel University. June 2007 onwards, the affiliation of BVM is with Gujarat Technological University. Infrastructural facilities at BVM include 25 classrooms and 8 tutorial rooms, well-equipped 35 laboratories and 1 workshop. Testing and consultancy facilities are available in the various laboratories. The college is recognized for testing of materials, BIS certifications, environmental auditing and calibrations, comprehensive computer and internet facilities, computerized library along with a large collection of video cassette and CDs, auditorium with a capacity of 400 seats and is rated as today's one of the best auditoriums of Vallabh Vidhyanagar campus. 6 drawing halls, 2 seminar halls and 1 multi-purpose hall. Administrative office. BVM is ranked among top 5 institutes in Gujarat Technological Universities encompassing 108 engineering institutes. The college
which started with only 3 engineering programs, now has 4-year degree courses in civil engineering, mechanical engineering, electrical engineering, computer engineering, electronics engineering, electronics and telecommunication engineering, information technology engineering, and production engineering. It also runs a part-time post-diploma degree course in mechanical engineering. Apart from this, college runs postgraduate and PhD programs in joint efforts with sister institutions, namely ISTAR, GSET, ADIT, and CCART engineering institutes in areas like environmental engineering, structural engineering, construction engineering and management, transportation system engineering, machine design, electrical power system, and computer engineering. BVM is a grant in aid institute managed by world-class educational trust Charutar Vidya Mandal. Eminent personalities like Bharat Ratna Shri Sardar Vallabh Bhai Patel, Shri Morarji Bhai Desai, ex-Prime Minister of India, Shri G.V. Mavlankar, first Speaker of Lok Sabha, Dr. H.M. Patel, ex-Finance and Home Minister, Government of India, was the chairman of Charutar Vidya Mandal for more than 3 decades. From the year 1994, Dr. C.L. Patel, an engineer with down-to-earth personality, utmost sincerity and honesty to the core, proved himself as a worthy successor. The present principal of BVM is Dr. F. S. Umrigar. Glimpses from past. The foundation stone of the ladies' hostel was laid by none other than stunningly dignified Lady Mountbatten. Nehru Chacha looks on spellbound as his global vision merges with the local vision. Chacha Nehru, taking interest in the nitty-gritty of the plan of BVM. Principal Amin, then chief engineer of CVM, reporting the progress of their cherished dreams to Lord Mountbatten at his residence. Famous freedom fighter Sri Rafi Ahmed Kirwai took keen interest and made many motivational suggestions. Visit of famous scientist C.V. Raman lent dazzling aura to the newly started institute. BVM celebrated its silver jubilee during 1972-73 and the golden jubilee during 1997-98. During 2007-2008, BVM celebrated its diamond jubilee in the august presence of Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, former President of India, and Sri Narendra Modi, Chief Minister of Gujarat, and numerous alumni who have been giving excellent account of themselves in India and abroad. Ignited minds exchanging sparks of ideas, knowledge, and experiences. In spite of their grinding schedules, the students of BVM have been taking active interest in non-scholastic activities which involve innovative and scientific bent to fun and entertainment. Their technological knowledge gets an extra edge with showcasing their talent during such talent shows. Cultural programs give them much needed respite. Recently, students of BVM have hosted mega events like Brahmastra 2009, Energia 2010, Uran 2011. BVM has future plans to upgrade present available infrastructure and to start new PG programs in Computer Aided Design, CAM Lab Manufacturing, Hydrology and Water Resource Management, Embedded System Design, Thermal Engineering, Computer Aided Structural Analysis and Design. To keep the pace with modern technology, the campus is getting geared for graduate and postgraduate programs in Defense Technology and Renewable Energy Research Center. Under the leadership of visionary Dr. C. L. Patel, Charutar Vidya Mandal has successfully implemented several new educational projects. It goes to his credit that subjects like mechatronics, e-commerce, valuation in real estate, plant and machinery, industrial health, safety and hygiene were first conceptualized and introduced here, making several firsts in the country. To take the academic community to the next level, Dr. C. L. Patel has mobilized financial resources of over $35 million in the past 1.5 decades. And has future plans of over $100 million expansions. He believes that work undertaken in the interest of society will never suffer for the want of funds. And this golden belief was conferred with an overwhelming support of donors from India and across the globe. The new Vallabh Vidhyanagar, developed over an area of 100 acres, is a self-contained satellite township with a massive investment and has its own modern amenities and infrastructure in place. Apart from comprising a pharmacy college, an engineering college, an Ayurvedic college and hospital, an institute of biotechnology and an industrial training center, this new township boasts of the first women's engineering college of the state. Charutar Vidya Mandal has recently entered into an MOU with Government of Gujarat to undertake massive expansion worth rupees 500 crores in the fields of education, training and research. A new proposed mega campus will have National Institute of Design, National School of Law, Polytechnic for Girls, a convention center for over 3,000 people, sports arena, stay area, and a central library. CVM has many more plans to add new bands to its existing spectrum, opening wide vistas of possibilities for generations to come. CVM is collecting sticks and is eagerly waiting for the sparks.